Now, of course, it's time for this one. I will unbox one for you. I know we've shown you these phones before. We've spoken about some part of it in the previews also. But now it's time to actually unbox one of them. This is the Samsung Galaxy S10. What I have is the S10 Plus. And I'm going to show you two colors. So our review unit was a blue colored one. And then we've got the white, especially for you, because the white almost came as a big surprise. Almost no one knew about the fact that the white was going to come to India. So I'll unbox this for you and showcase exactly what it looks like. So as we can see, the rest of it is all the same. Bilkul wahi cheez hai, but now to get that color out. So as you can see, this then is the white from Samsung. As you can also see, I'm literally with my magical fingers holding it and it's floating in the air. No, it's not. I'm holding it with the plastic tag. So lots about this phone. But I have to tell you the two or three things that really set it apart. So the design part of it, the screen with that punch hole camera is the other thing. We will talk about that in the review, that because it's got two cameras in the front, does the punch hole become too much? Then we've got the fact that it's actually got optics like no other phone. It's got wireless charging. So they also released the Samsung Buds. Just put the entire case of the Buds behind the phone and it can actually charge that or any other phone and does it pretty quick. So one is wireless charging, one is doing it quick enough for it to really make a difference. So like I said, we'll take a quick look at this. Of course, like I said, the blue review phone. But when I come back, I have a question for you.
There's a new star in the galaxy and this one will make you look at it with awe while contemplating how to muster up the ransom being demanded to own it. We have the new and shiny Samsung S10 Plus with us for review and we're here to answer the question. Is this the S10 you want to own, considering the options Samsung has laid out before you in this new flagship range? There is the S10, the bigger S10 Plus, and of course the S10e, a more affordable option. For this review, we'll stick to the bigger Galaxy phone, the S10 Plus. Let's start out with the display. The S10 Plus comes with a massive 6.4-inch edge-to-edge screen and the big deal here is Samsung's next-generation Infinity O display with a punch-hole design for the front-facing cameras. While this punch-hole design does look a lot like a notch, but we're not complaining because of the wallpapers which make the screen look almost bezel-less. And yes, this is the biggest Samsung screen on a phone yet. So what you get is a 93.1% screen-to-body ratio, which doesn't disappoint. The colors are vivid in daylight and, might we add, with great detailing. The display also deserves a special mention for having HDR 10 Plus support for superior contrast, which makes content consumption a delight on this phone. We also get an ultrasonic fingerprint sensor on the front and we hear that Qualcomm's ultrasonic technology makes this more secure than some Chinese flagships. We tried unlocking the phone with a wet finger and it still worked, though not as quickly as optical scanners.
In display, ultrasonic fingerprint is a world's first that Samsung Galaxy S10 is bringing in. It makes your information in the phone as secure as a vault because it really sends out waves, ultrasonic sound waves into the phone in the in-display, and through that there's no spoofing possible. So whether it's wet conditions or it's extreme weather conditions, you'll be able to use it and no one can spoof your information away.
The prism blue color is reflective and looks stunning in daylight, though it is a fingerprint magnet. The S10 Plus, unlike the iPhone XS Max, which seems to be its competition when it comes to specs and price, is very comfortable to hold. And of course, you get Gorilla Glass 6 on both front and back, which we are thankful for. There's a dedicated Bixby button below the volume rocker, which feels a bit redundant. Like all Samsung phones, this one also has a 3.5mm headphone jack, which gets a thumbs up from us. The S10 Plus runs on Android 9 Pie, coated with Samsung's own One UI, which is quite different from stock Android, frankly. The S10 Plus runs on the new chip on the block, literally, but that depends on the part of the world you're in. While US markets can enjoy the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855, which makes the phones faster, smoother and more battery efficient, India has to settle for Samsung's own Exynos 9820 chip. A screen like this demands a mammoth battery and the new Samsung S10 Plus comes with 4100mAh of juice, giving us around 2 days of moderate usage. We also tried Samsung's new wireless power share feature, which transforms the back of the S10 Plus into a big Qi charging mat. We tried charging the Galaxy Buds with it and it worked well. The S10 Plus comes with a triple lens rear camera setup with a 12 megapixel regular lens, a 12 megapixel telephoto lens and a new 16 megapixel ultra wide lens. Our images were vivid with great detailing, but the real prowess of the camera is in its ultra wide lens. So you can fit a lot into a single image. And if you turn on the scene optimizer feature, the inbuilt AI will give you the best shot suggestion, which is helpful while framing. There is a dual front shooter with a 10 megapixel and 8 megapixel lens, and selfies are pretty flawless if that's what you're after. Live focus, bokeh and other options work well. And for anyone looking for Instagrammable photos, this phone can do it all. Now Samsung believes there's an S10 for everyone. The Galaxy S10 starts at ₹66,900, the S10 Plus at ₹73,900, and a more affordable S10e starts at ₹55,900. Storage options go right up to a whopping 1 TB. The Cell Guru verdict. The Samsung S10 Plus leaves no room for complaints. Its display, fingerprint sensor, wireless power share feature, and battery life make a strong case to buy the phone right away. But at nearly ₹74,000 for the base model of the S10 Plus, Samsung has made a sizable hike from the last Galaxy phone, attracting competition from the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. But if a reliable phone with excellent specs backed by a mighty brand is on your shopping list, your search stops now.